put it in the land of compassion and aesthetics. Now, the first one.
It takes a poet.
Yeah. Okay. The first one. When Winter in Lisbon first came out, it was widely read by normal readers, you know? But in academia was immediately understood as a kind of postmodern contraption, you know? A kind of culturalist creation lacking real life, because there are so many references to movies, to music, and things like that, no? But deep down, what I think the novel is, or tried to be, or what I tried to do at the time, was to tell the story of an amour fou. I mean, I was really serious about the characters. I was really serious about trying to portray real people falling in love and getting desperately after each other. There is not a cultural game there. Maybe there are, I was too young, and we are, as I told you earlier, when you are young, you are eager, you are anxious to show up all your cultural references, no? But otherwise, the novel is a very simple love story about two people who try to meet and who...
Well, not too simple. I've seen simpler.
Well, the basic is simpler, no? Yeah. And the second was the other Catholicism, no? That's a serious one. But when I remember I was invited to a panel in New York a few years ago about religion and belief, in God, and things like that, no? And there were, I think, four of us. There was a lady who was Jewish, there was a Muslim, there was a Protestant, there was me. And the only one who had no connection whatsoever with faith was me. Because I had got rid of any religious feeling very early in my life for a simple reason. And the reason is, for me, religion, Catholic religion, was something absolutely connected to the dictatorship and more closely connected to those terrible priests that were in charge of education when I was a kid. It is that simple. So you react, as a teenager, you react against all that, and you react, and you say to yourself, whatever these people say, I'm against. These people believe in God. I don't believe in God. So my connection, or my lack of connection with religion, was absolutely political. I didn't want to have anything to do with these people. I didn't believe anything they would tell me, because they were absolutely stained by their complicity with the awful dictatorship, no? They were cynical. The Catholic Church was the major ideological benefactor of the dictatorship in Spain. So, at a very early age, I developed a lack of intimate and emotional connection with religion, because religion was about power, was about receiving blows in your face, you didn't go to mass. So, but I know that there is a private and personal connection with the spirituality that should be paid attention to as well. But this was lost on me, because I didn't have a chance to develop this kind of relationship. No? Because it was so clear, it was then me. There was no middle ground. There was no compromise. No. Later on, I have, because I have something I have is a deep sense. I don't exactly know how to put it. A deep sense of the sacred, no, of holiness. There is, I mean, in nature, or in music, or in experiences like that, or some things that you learn from science, no? When you learn about the complexity of nature, there is a sense of the need of contemplation, which is not mystical. It's only paying attention to the real. And I think that people I know can enjoy this experience, and I respect this. I deeply respect it, and sometimes I can even envy it. Letting aside the fact that for me, my main concern about religion is that, having suffered so much, the intrusion of religion in my private life and in my country's private lives, my main concern is that religion lays aside from ordinary life. I mean, those people who are in charge, I don't want to be saved. If you want to save yourself, good for you. But please don't save me. This is my that's why my connection with Paul, because on the other hand, my imagination has been, I mean, Catholicism is a very rich visual experience in many ways, no? You have the churches, you have the saints, you have
all the art,
and this is important
music.
Art.
Music.
Music, and I respond very, very strongly to that, no? But I think that I respond to religious music much more strongly than many religious people, no? At least the Catholics, because they have completely forsaken their musical heritage, no? So you go to church and they are playing electric guitar, no, with pop music, and they don't care about Bach. So I care about Bach, and every time, that every Easter, I almost religiously listen to the Passion according to St. Matthew, but I see that my Catholic friends don't care that much about the music, you know?